Continuing from last video, in this video, we will be writing some logic for our game to make the things we set in our last video actually work. In the assets folder, we will add an art folder. This is where our art assets will be kept. For this video, I have two art assets I will be using to show you how we can dynamically change our display art. I decided to go for an art resolution of 456 by 456. Because I found that it stops the scroll bar from blocking the text. We will go to the logic folder and add a script named content data. In the content data script, we will write this code. Don't worry, I will come back to explain it. To test the script, I will be attaching it to the game screen roots node for now. It looks like we got an error. We have to make a folder for our story. Our story will be in the JSON format. In the story folder, we will add a new text file named sample-story.json. Open it up and place our story here. I have written a short interactive story in JSON format here. Each story block consists of a name, title, picture, narrative text, choices, and outcomes or outputs of said choices. Going back to the contents data script, we adjust the dialog path to the JSON file location. If we run it, we see that we can read our JSON file. Now that we know we can access our JSON, let's detach the script from the game screen node and make use of the layouts we set up last episode. Let's begin by attaching a script to the content container node. We will name it content container and make sure to save it in the logic folder. File organization is good practice. Now, we select the label, texture rect, rich text label, vbox container, and the choice containers. Right-click and select the access as unique name option. I'm going to be adding a fourth choice container. Now, in the script, we start by referencing the nodes we marked as the unique name. We create two variables to store our JSON story data as a dictionary and another to keep track for our story block. In the ready function, we set our contents data variable to contentData.contentsDictionary. The contents data would be gotten from the content data scripts we wrote earlier. We will be accessing it as an autoload. We'll also set the current page variable to the name of the first story block. In our case, it is 000 prologue. We then set the display content to the current page. We also connect our choice button signals to a process choice button. Now, I will go ahead and make the contents data script an autoload. An autoload is a way to make a script available globally across the scenes in the project. We have this error because in our contents data script, we made a class using the same name. Now, I will go to the contents data script and delete the class. Now we can go ahead and create the autoload. In the content container script, we can write the process choice function. This will process our choices by checking if our choice has an output, resetting the scroll container, and setting our contents to be the output value. Here, we write the setContents function that sets the title, picture, narrative text, and choice buttons. In the setTitle function, we get the title value from the output value and set it. In the setPicture function, we check if the output value has a picture and set it if it does. In the setNarrative function, we get the narrative text from the output value and set it. In the setChoiceButton function, we hide all the choice buttons first. We then set and show the text for each button that has text. We can go to the choice container and attach a script named ChoiceButton. We create a custom signal, export a choice index variable and a variable referencing the label of our choice container. We create a new signal for the button press. Make sure the choice container you are connecting to is the parent of the button. In the button press function, we emit our custom signal and we make a function to set the text of our button. We make sure to attach the script to the other choice containers and connect their buttons. Now, we set the button's choice indexes. Now, let's go back to the contents data script. In the script, we export the path to the dialog.json file. We have a phrase number variable, a choice variable to indicate when the dialog is finished, and a contents dictionary to contain all the data contents from the JSON. In the ready function, we call the loadContentDictionary function. In the loadContentDictionary function, we open the JSON file with the content, parse it, and store it in the contentsDictionary variable. We can create a function that can get the value of the contentsDictionary. This next phase function moves to the next phase or block of the dialog. We run and get an error. According to the error log, content container is not found. The problem is in the code. I didn't put a space between content and container while naming the nodes. So I can correct it by removing the space and renaming it as content container without the space. We run and another error. It looks like we forgot to put brackets at the end of this function here. We run again and it works, but it did not load our picture. So let's inspect the JSON. It looks like I gave the wrong picture directory here. A quick fix and everything should work now. You might notice this weird space between your narrative text and choices. You can leave them if you like, but if you don't, go to the node that renders your narrative text, which is the rich text label. In the layout, set the custom minimum size to 0. Now, I think this is much better. Another thing you might notice is that if you have very long choice text, this happens. To fix it, you go to the label node of each choice container and set auto wrap to word smart. Now, we have this nicer button behavior. In the next episode, we will look at how to set up a stats system that can affect the choices and outcomes that can be made. For example, being unable to choose a cast spell option if mana is low, or it branching out to a story block where you tried to cast but failed and died. If you enjoyed this video, please like, subscribe, and hit the notification bell so you won't miss any future updates. Leave a comment if you have any questions or suggestions. Thanks for watching.